within the game. That was the perfect call out there. Once he got the block, he made a move, and he was headed to the end zone.
the home of the Super Bowl 52 champions, Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Los Angeles Chargers and the Philadelphia Eagles. Here's the kicker, Jake Elliott, ready to get this one started. And off we go from Lincoln Financial Field. DeAndre Carter now from his end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. On the first play, wants to pass it. Finds the open man. It's Mike Williams. And he'll be corralled right around the 34. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Here's the first carry for Austin Eckler. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three.
Not a huge carry there on first down, but not all of them will be. But still, all in all, a positive play for the offense. It's all about picking up at least a few to set up what you're going to do here on second down.
On second and 7, Herbert. He'll get this out wide to Eckler. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion, and that'll leave him with a 3rd and 2. Herbert now. That's caught, and it's Eckler again. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. Call it a gain of 5 as they move the sticks. Back to throw here, Herbert. Oh, that's into a double team, and it's intercepted. And the Eagles are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line. So we see it right here on the opening drive, throwing the football in these snowing conditions. Going to be very, very tough. You wonder if they're going to rethink the aerial attack going forward.
It will be interesting, and it'll be a debate, because most of the quarterbacks that we know, they believe they can throw through anything. They don't care if it's rain, snow, it doesn't matter, as long as they get a chance to throw the football. And I think a lot of coaches think that in these conditions, let's throw it early before things get worse.
And a solid run here as he'll pick his way down to the 42-yard line. On first and 10, it's Hurts. And this is caught by Watkins. Touchdown, Philadelphia! Quez Watkins, 42 yards. And the Eagles use the early turnover to get on the board first here in this one. On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. Now, these are not going to be easy on a cold, snowy night, but this one is up and through. Now, after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. From his end zone, here comes Carter. And not a great return here. He'll make it back only to the 10-yard line.
Anytime you feel the kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
The Charger drive about to get going. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, wound up leading to a touchdown the other way. How do you approach drive number 2?
Going back to your game plan.
And this turns into disaster. He's not going to get forward progress. That'll be a safety.
The goal here is about getting any kind of positive yardage in this spot, because you don't care who, you don't care how. You just want to try and buy a little space and get away from your own end zone. But in this spot, the defense was all over that play and equally motivated to stick him with a safety.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. That one tipped and it's incomplete. But good hands there defensively. It's second down.
Yes, sir. How about an attaboy there on first down? Got his hand in and knocked it away.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Hurts a handoff to Sanders. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Another run here with Sanders. And space tough to come by there as he'll get maybe a yard to the 37. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Throwing is Hurts. And that falls to the ground, incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave him trying to convert on third and 9. That's caught by the big tight end, Dallas Goedert. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 41-yard line. Hurts sets up to throw it. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. But fortunately, he's able to recover his own fumble, or that could have been trouble. Points 1, 2, and 3 in their defensive game plan was to get to the quarterback and knock the ball free. They did it there. Luckily, offense hangs on to it.
Yeah, that's got to serve as a wake-up call, though, because they can't afford to let the ball go over to the deep.
And the ball is knocked out and picked up by the Chargers. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line.
Whenever we call a game that's in the snow, we have to focus a little bit more, trying to make sure we've got the right numbers on players that we're calling right, the right guys in the game. Think about the guys on the field. Their focus has to really increase as well because so many things coming at you, you got to make sure that you're really locked in on taking care of the ball.
Or if you don't, you cough it up like they did right there. Meanwhile, Herbert's throw taken in by Palmer. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. After one, it's 9-0. They'll fake the handoff. Now Herbert. Here's a diving catch right side. And that's good for a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll leave him with a second and just a few inches left. Herbert will give this one to Eckler. And he'll go down at the 28. 2 yards, good enough for a first.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
Herbert on first down now. Throw left side is hauled in by Palmer. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. On second down, Eckler. And a short gain here, down to the 22. In search of 4 yards here to pick up the first down. Off the play fake to Eckler, it's Herbert. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. It'll be a loss of 2, maybe 3 on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down. And this one is right through. And they are on the board. It's now 9-3. So the defense are able to force their first turnover of the game, and then they add on to that by getting the field goal.
And you don't just want to take the ball away from your opponent, partner. You want to make them hurt as well. And if you don't score yourself on defense, turn it over to your offense and have them put points on the board.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. Yeah, last drive, obviously not what you're looking for. You've got the lead. You got to protect the football.
So, in other words, someone got lucky because they've been moving the ball really well and wearing them down. In this case, though, giving up the football doesn't make them very happy. They can't wait to get back out there and atone for it.
Yeah, try to atone for it here on this drive. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Another run with Sanders. Takes it to the 26, just a one-yard gain. 5 yards on first down, but now just a one-yard pickup there on second. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. An extra defensive back on the field for the Chargers now on third down. Hurts. Flushed out right. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. Give him seven on the tuck and run, and it'll get him a new set of downs. On first and 10, it's Sanders. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 42 yards rushing for him now on just six carries to this point. But first down, Hurts. And that nearly intercepted. Well, the free safety roaming into position almost had it, but it's second down. Throwing again on second and 10. Hurts. Oh, it's complete. A diving grab there by Brown. He's got his first catch here before halftime, and it goes for a first down. Now a timeout called for by the offense, as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. So from the 36 now, first and 10. They go back to the ground with Sanders. And maybe a little over pursuit there as he's able to take this down to the 25-yard line. Here's Hurts to throw. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Able to make something out of nothing there. 17 yards and a first down. They'll throw now on the final play. And this is caught. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Quez Watkins in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles would extend their lead here just before halftime. You always worry about the plant foot in the snow, but no problems there. And the lead now stands at 13. So with 3 seconds remaining in the half, they will line up to kick this one away. Pulls it in at the 13. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. This snow front that has socked much of the East Coast not going away as we are back to it in the second half. A very interesting call and one that backfires. I know they're losing, Charles, but boy, to start the second half with the onside kick, risky.
Felt like a sense of urgency from their side, coupled with, you and I both know the special teams coordinators, they sell their key plays each and every week to the head coach, don't they? And I guarantee he's been selling this one. We can get it, coach, we can get it. And that came together with that sense of urgency you talked about.
Right back to Sanders on first down. And he'll snag about 5 yards down to the 32.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Hawk 70, Hawk 70. It's a second down run with Sanders. They find some open field here. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15. We often give credit to the O-line there. Two tight end formation. Those tight ends block pretty well also.
Yeah, and that's one of the most dynamic positions in football now. The tight ends who can block at the line of scrimmage at the point of attack, and they can also get downfield and catch the football.
He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four. They'll go again with Sanders. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. If this defense wants to stay in this ballgame, they've got to start ending some drives. That helps.
And they have to look ahead at what they expect the offense to do. And right now with that lead, that's run the football. So you don't just stack the line of scrimmage. You have to get upfield and try and make some plays in their backfield.
And he picks up the first as he's able to take it down to the 7-yard line. It's a gain of four there, and it gives him a new set of downs.
Someone's been having a good game so far, and you know something? A lot of it's been power running. They decided to turn him loose again on third down, didn't they?
They did indeed. He delivered the tough yards. They'll run here with Gainwell. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. Two of their 3 red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. Again, it'll be Gainwell. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
3 tight ends up front here, third and goal. On the sneak, it's Hurts. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line. Now a timeout called for by the defense. It's just their first, so 2 remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. Now a timeout called for by the offense. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. Going for it with Sanders, and he's in for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders punching it in from a yard away, and the Eagles' decision to go for it pays off with 6 points. So that, Charles, a big decision there on fourth and goal, and it works out.
And that is an example of a coach who's confident in his team. He didn't look at it as a gamble at all. He looked at it as belief. Great starting field position. Let's go ahead and deliver. And they do.
And he is into the end zone again as he scores both the touchdown and the 2-point conversion to extend this lead. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20. The Charger drive about to get going.
I kind of feel like they've reached a do-or-die point in this game, Charles. If they're going to try to pull off an impressive comeback, it has to start right here, right now.
Yeah, now they've got a final chance to get out of this situation, but they also understand they've got to move the ball and move it fast. In addition, they need to save as much time.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted.
Picked off by Hassan Reddick. And the Eagles are going to have the football here at their own 35-yard line.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores. But, yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Second and 10 now. Third quarter action from Philadelphia, PA. He'll look to throw. That is caught. It's the tight end Goddard. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield.
That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
Oh, a lot of credit to the play caller here. He saw the design in his mind and implemented it. A little zone stretcher here because they start the tight end on the left side of formation and set him on a crossing route. And this works really well when you can find that space between levels, and they were able to do so for good yardage.
And as they come to the line, they will not be able to get off another play as time has run out on this third quarter. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll fake the give to Sanders, and now Hurts. He'll hit Watkins on the crossing route. And he's brought to the ground with another first down at the Chargers' 20-yard line. A really nice gain of 25 yards. They'll run with Sanders up the middle. Gets around him, and he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. 106 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. And finding room to work, he's down to the 2-yard line. He'll pick up 7 there on the first down keeper.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with the lead, you'd love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on...
And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders with his second touchdown of the night. And the Eagles up the lead to 4 scores now here in this fourth quarter. Elliott Good with a PAT, and that'll increase their lead to 28. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. A fairly short kick from the 14. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. Well, it's been a struggle so far for this offense, Charles. It's not only that they haven't been able to put the points up, but really stringing on Herbert, his third interception. And he takes this one back into the end zone. Defense gets a pick 6 TD. Well, this one was already ugly, and now it's just kind of becoming a feast on the defensive side of the football.
Yeah, partner, this is a unit that knows they've got this game in the bag with this huge lead, and it's going to drive their coaches crazy because they're telling them play it straight, do all the right things, but these guys are going to be freewheeling now. All of them are going to take chances, and that one pays off with an INT and a return for 6.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. From his end zone, here comes Carter. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The Charger drive about to get going. Where we stand right now in the fourth quarter, this one pretty much out of reach. And Charles, I know they're going to be disappointed about several things with this ball game, but the self-inflicted wounds, they've had several turnovers. You would have to think that's going to be something they're going to discuss heavily in the film session in the coming days.
You're absolutely right about that, partner, because they're going to have to sit in that film room and watch every error that they made and figure out how to not do it in the future. And mentally, I think a lot of the guys are already starting to think about, okay, how do we put this behind us and get better for the next time out? This, they'll use as motivation for the rest of the time that they play to hopefully never be in this type of situation again.
Play action this time for Justin Herbert. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception picked off by Kaiser White. And now look at this, big gain, but a fumble. And the
Chargers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, do you want to unpack that one, or do you want me to?
You're the boss.
We get the interception, then really he's just too loose with the football on the return, and he coughs it right back up the other way.
I've seen this happen in an NFL game, and boy, did it cost them once.
And now here's another interception picked up by James Bradbury.
And the Eagles are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. Now the Eagles will use the second of their timeouts. That's going to leave them with just one remaining here in this fourth quarter. And the punt team is out there. It's not fourth down. Maybe the cold weather here freezing their brain a bit. And this one will be touched down right at the 30-yard line. The Charger drive about to get going. They're sort of seeing themselves spiral out of control. Let's see if they can get things back on track. And my goodness, another interception. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick.
And with this advantage, this defense knew that passes were coming, and they stayed in position, Charles, and picked one off here in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, what a...